Hello students, this is class 10th, subject English, chapter 7th, that is going on, Glimpses of India. And today we are going to start with our first lecture of part 3, Tea from Assam. So let us begin. Topics to be covered today. First of all, we shall read introduction of the author, then chapter sketch. And the name of the author is Arup Kumar Datta. After that, we shall read about the characters, then introduction of the chapter, and after introduction of the chapter, we shall read overview of the chapter, means the whole complete explanation of the chapter Tea from Assam. Then at last, we shall discuss homework solution of lecture 2 of Coorg. So let us begin with the introduction of the author Arup Kumar Datta. Introduction of the author Arup Kumar Datta. Arup Kumar Datta is an Indian writer and journalist. He was born on 2nd of July in 1946. He spent his early life in Jorhat in the tea growing Indian state of Assam. At the age of 8, he was admitted to Lawrence School, Sanawar in Himachal Pradesh, from where he passed his senior Cambridge examination in 1962. After school, Datta joined Ramjas College under the University of Delhi, from where he completed his Bachelor of Arts in English Literature in 1966. He went on to finish his post-graduation in English Literature from the University of Delhi in 1969. He is an Indian writer and journalist based out of Guwahati in Assam. He has written 17 adventure novels for young people and 14 books for adults. He has also won numerous awards, including the Shankar's Award in 1979, conferred to mark the International Year of the Child. Means he was awarded Shankar Award and the Civilian Award. So this is all about Arup Kumar Datta, the author of Tea from Assam. So now let us move ahead. Now chapter sketch. The chapter Glimpses of India, this is 7th chapter of first flight book, consists of 3 parts. These 3 parts are, first is A Baker from Goa by Lucio Rodrigues. Then next is Coorg. It is written by Lokesh Abrol. And third part is Tea from Assam. This is written by Arup Kumar Datta. So we have already done A Baker from Goa as well as Coorg. So today we are going to start this third part, Tea from Assam. So let us begin. The first part is a pen portrait of a traditional Goan village baker or padar, who still has an important place in Goan culture, although the Portuguese have left India long the back. Pen portrait, it means describing in words about a person in such a way that its picture is framed in our mind. So this chapter is complete description of a traditional Goan village baker. The whole chapter revolves around Goan baker, and those bakers were also called padar. The second part is a pen portrait of Coorg. Coorg or Kodagu, it is the smallest district of Karnataka. And it is famous for evergreen rainforest, spices and coffee plantation. And the third part, that is Tea from Assam. It is about the tea plantations in Assam. Tea from Assam is an interesting story about tea, its history and significance. And in this story, we get a glimpse of the tea plantation of Assam. About the characters, third part is Tea from Assam, and there are mainly two characters, Rajveer and Pranjal. So the story revolves around these two characters. Rajveer, he is a youngster from Delhi. He is a person who is always excited to learn about new things. Pranjal, he is a friend and classmate of Rajveer. He belongs to Assam. Let us read introduction of the chapter Tea from Assam, third part of Glimpses of India. Tea from Assam introduction. The lesson is about two friends, Pranjal and Rajveer, who are traveling to Pranjal's hometown, Assam, for the summer vacation. Assam is known as the tea country. It has the largest concentration of plantation in the world. So these two boys, Rajveer and Pranjal, are traveling to Assam, and Pranjal's father is a manager in a tea garden of Assam. He invites Rajveer to Assam. Rajveer tells Pranjal different things about the discovery of tea. During their journey, they discuss about the various legends that are known to have discovered tea. The story tells us about the popularity of tea as a beverage. So, this is an interesting story about tea, its history and significance. In this story, we get a glimpse of the tea plantation of Assam. Rajveer is very excited about his journey because he was going there first time. Rajveer then tells Pranjal about the Indian and Chinese legends about discovery of tea. Chinese legend was about a Chinese emperor, and in Indian legend he tells about Bodhidharma. He also tells that it was discovered by a Chinese emperor in 2700 BC. Means tea was discovered by a Chinese emperor in 2700 BC. So this is all about introduction of this chapter. Now let us move ahead. Now let us read overview of the chapter. Chapter is 7th, Glimpses of India, and this is third part of this chapter, Tea from Assam. Let us start. First heading is Journey to Assam. As I have already told you that there are mainly two characters in this story, Rajveer and Pranjal. Rajveer and Pranjal are traveling to Assam by train, as Pranjal has invited Rajveer to visit his home during the summer vacation. Rajveer is very excited to see the beautiful scenery of greenery. Pranjal and Rajveer are two close friends. They study in Delhi. So Pranjal hails from Assam and his parents live there. Pranjal's father even is the manager of a tea garden. So, Pranjal and Rajveer, they both were going to Assam. Rajveer was very happy and very excited to see the tea plantation outside. Rajveer tells Pranjal that over 80 crore cups of tea are drunk every day throughout the world. Now next heading is Wonderful Greenery. Rajveer looks at the scenery outside and is mesmerized, means got fascinated, got attracted by its beauty. The view from the train was also panoramic. There was greenery outside and Rajveer was very happy to see it. The soft green paddy fields gave way to tea bushes. Tea bushes spread as far as the eye could see. So that was really a magnificent view. There were tea bushes and the tea plants outside. There was also a building with smoke coming out of all chimneys. It was a tea garden. Assam is called a tea country. Now next heading is Chinese legend about discovery of tea. Rajveer told two legends about discovery of tea to Pranjal. First one is Chinese legend and another is Indian legend. So there are many legends about the discovery of tea. The Chinese legend is given here. There was a Chinese emperor who used to boil water before drinking it. A few leaves of the twigs were burnt under the pot and then they fell into the water that gave a delicious flavor to it. Actually, they were tea leaves. So the same thing is given here. Actually, there was a Chinese emperor who used to boil water before drinking it. A few leaves of the tree were burnt under the pot and then they fell into the water that gave a delicious flavor to it. Actually, they were tea leaves. So this is Chinese legend about tea. So now let us read about Indian legend. Indian legend about discovery of tea. Indian legend tells that a Buddhist monk cut off his eyelids because he felt sleepy during meditations. 10 tea plants grew out of these eyelids. The leaves of these plants, when put in hot water and drunk, drove away sleep. So the leaves of those plants were considered tea plants. Now next heading, it is first drunk in China. Tea was first drunk in China as far back as 2700 BC. The words like chai and chini are of Chinese origin. From China, it spread to Europe and then to Asia. Earlier, tea was drunk more as a medicine than as a beverage. Now, next heading is train reached at its destination. At last, the train reached at its destination. Both the friends, Rajveer and Pranjal, deboarded the train at Mariana Junction. And Pranjal's father received and took them to Dekiaveri Tea Estate, where he was deputed. There were tea bushes on both sides of the road. So the boys alighted at Mariani Junction. Soon they were driving towards Dekiaveri, the tea garden managed by Pranjal's father. Groups of tea pluckers with bamboo baskets on their backs and wearing plastic aprons plucking the newly sprouted leaves could be seen everywhere. The best tea is obtained during the period of May to July. So it is considered that May to July are the best months for tea plantation. Now, next heading, it is Rajveer was appreciated. Rajveer told Mr. Barua that May to July are the best months for tea plantation. At this, Pranjal's father told him that he had good knowledge about tea and Rajveer had done his homework properly well. At this, Rajveer told that he wanted to seek more information about it. So this is the overview of the chapter Tea from Assam. Now let us discuss your homework. Homework is to read the chapter thoroughly and find out the answers of given questions. Read the following extract carefully and answer the questions that follow. So the extract is Chai Garam Garam Chai. A vendor called out in a high pitched voice. He came up to their window and asked, Chai Sahab, give us 2 cups, Pranjal said. They sipped the steaming hot liquid. Almost everyone in their compartment was drinking tea too. Do you know that over 80 crore cups of tea are drunk every day throughout the world? Rajveer said. Phew, exclaimed Pranjal. Tea really is very popular. So this is the extract. Question 1. How many cups of tea are drunk every day throughout the world? Second question is, where were Pranjal and Rajveer when this conversation took place? Question 3. Find the word in the extract which is an expression of astonishment. And the last question from this extract is, who was selling the tea and where was he? So find out the answers of these given questions. Next question, second question, where were Rajveer and Pranjal going and why? Third question, what did Rajveer see while looking outside from the train? Question 4, why did Pranjal's father say that Rajveer had done his homework before visiting Assam? Question 5, write down the 2 stories related to the discovery of tea. So students, you are supposed to read the chapter thoroughly and find out the answers of these questions, write the answers and send me the snapshots of these answers at my email address. I hope that you all have understood what to do. So now let us discuss homework solution of lecture 2 of Coorg. Coorg, that is second part of chapter 7th, Glimpses of India. So this is class 10th, subject English, and this is homework solution of lecture 2 of Coorg. Question was, read the passage and answer the following questions. Passage was, the river Kaveri obtains its water from the hills and forests of Coorg. Mahasir, a large freshwater fish, abound in these waters. Kingfishers dive for their catch, while squirrels and langurs drop partially eaten fruit for the mischief of enjoying the splash and the ripple effect in the clear water. Elephants enjoy being bathed and scrubbed in the river by their mahouts. So the question, first question is, which river flows from the hills of Coorg? So the answer is, the river Kaveri flows from the hills of Coorg. Now next question, why do the squirrels drop partially eaten fruit in the river? So the answer is, the squirrels drop partially eaten fruit in the river because they enjoy the splash and ripple effect created by the fruit hitting the water. The next question, find the word in the extract which means same as wave. So the word is ripple. Ripple from the extract means wave. Next question, what do elephants enjoy by their mahouts? So elephants enjoy being bathed and scrubbed by their mahouts. Now next question, how has the Coorgi tradition of courage and bravery recognized in modern India? So the answer is, the Coorgi tradition of courage and bravery has been recognized by awarding the Coorg Regiment with the most number of gallantry awards. Means the Coorg regiment is the most decorated regiment. They have got many bravery awards. Besides, the Coorgis are the only Indians allowed to carry firearms without a license. They can carry firearms without license. Next question. Describe Coorg's weather. When is it most pleasant for the tourist to visit Coorg? So, the answer is, the weather of Coorg is pleasant during the months from September to March. During that time, the weather is perfect with some showers thrown in for good measure. But during the monsoon, it receives heavy rainfall. It rains so heavily that no visitors go at that time. Next question. It is describe any two tourist places of Coorg. So the answer is, the climb of Brahmagiri Hills brings into a panoramic view of the entire misty landscape of Coorg. A walk across the rope bridge leads to the 64-acre island of Nisargadhama. So these are two tourist places of Coorg. Now next question. How do Coorg's location, people and natural features add to the diversity of India? So the answer is, Coorg is beautifully located and described as a piece of heaven that must have drifted from the kingdom of God. Means this place is very beautiful. It has rolling hillsides with a pollution-free river. River Kaveri flows here, and forests teeming with wildlife. Here nature exists in its pristine glory, which adds to the diversity of India. Further, it has coffee and spice plantations, quite different from the rest of India. The local people, the Kadavs, are a martial race. Of course, they are well known for their hospitality, just like all Indians. So all these features of Coorg add to the diversity of our country, India. So do your homework and send me the snapshots of homework on my email ID. And I hope you have understood what I have been taught to you. If you like our videos, please press like button and subscribe our channel. Thank you.